Blackstone Audio presents Pimp by Ken Bruen and Jason Starr. This book is read by Peter Berkrot. For all those who did fuck all to help us or give us a review. Disclaimer. Any resemblance to persons living or dead is not only intentional, but damn necessary. 1. He is a hustler. The guy's a pimp. But that's not what I'm talking about. Elmore Leonard, La Brava. Max, Maximus, Maximum. In the bathroom of a tenement apartment in Harlem, Max Fisher stared at his reflection. The plastic surgery had hurt like a son of a bitch, and only now was the bruising beginning to fade. What looked back at Max was like Philip Seymour Hoffman after the autopsy. Max, a master of self-delusion, saw a youngish Jack Nicholson and gave the thumbs up to the face, went, "You still got it, kid." He was dressed in what used to be called a lounging suit, but hadn't done any lounging since Sinatra had hit town. It was bright yellow, and Max's latest babe muttered, "Looks like a canary's abortion, man." Her name was Precious, and the fact that she was neither young nor precious was not apparent to Max. She must have been 50, had ratty gray dreads, was missing a few teeth. She was Jamaican slash West Indian, emphasis on the slash. She'd recently done a 16-year stretch at Coxsackie for stabbing her sister in the face. This was what Max had liked most about her, though, that she had a past. It was nice to have something in common with a babe. Though Max, of course, had only been in prison at Attica for a few months before he escaped, it was the highlight of his life. He looked back on it the way soldiers looked at war. He'd risen up against the enemy, goddamn Aryans, and defeated all of them. Fuck, where was his parade? Precious went on. "You're not seriously wearing that, are you? You're going to be chased by a swarm of bees, man." Max had been in a daze lately, trying to get his shit together, and he wasn't sure exactly how long he'd known Precious. 3 days? A week? She was so annoying he wouldn't have kept her around at all if he didn't need her now for her contacts. She was going, "Come on, Maxie. I can't be going around the city with you, looking the way you be looking, embarrassing me. And how old is that jacket you wearing anyway, man? It looks like something you found in the Salvation Army. I think I seen my Uncle Kuvis be wearing that jacket one time. In 1972. And that collar, man, he's so hideous it makes my eyes water from the pain. Nobody be wearing bright yellow jackets anymore, man. You're getting dressed for a drug deal, not let's make a deal." Precious was laughing now, on a roll, enjoying her own dumb jokes. Great. So now he was dating the Jamaican Don Rickles. How'd that happen? Max, sick of her lip, went, "I'm sick of your lip. If you knew who you were talking to, you'd realize how stupid you sound. The Max isn't some schmo from buttfuck. The Max knows style. I'm what we Americans call a trendsetter, and I don't have to watch Netflix to know that yellow is the new black." Precious, still laughing, went, "Please, man, you are the most unfashionable man I ever seen. You look like you get dressed in the dark and go shopping in the dark, too." She continued, clapping, giving herself a round of applause. Meanwhile, Max looked at her stone-faced. He liked that they were both homicidal and that she was big-busted. Had to be 38s, E's or F's. And he thought she had a sultry, jazzy look, kind of like a homicidal Whoopi Goldberg. But the cons were starting to outweigh the pros. Her biggest con? She talked too much. Didn't women know that if you want to keep a man around, you gotta learn how to, as they say in Ireland, shut the fuck up? What was he doing with this dreadlocked bitch anyway? He had enough problems. He didn't need another one. He wished he could remember how he'd met her. Shit. His memory was turning into a serious issue.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.